Well, some breaking news tonight. The saga, more than 2 years in the making, has just come to a conclusion. The U.S. Border Patrol has reached a settlement with a comedian who sued them for an incident at the Spokane Intermodal Center.
You may remember this case. Our Casey Decker has been following the story since it started back in 2019. Today, in an exclusive interview, he talked with comedian about what it means to finally have a resolution. Casey.
Well, Whitney, this story gained national attention in part because it highlighted a controversial Border Patrol practice, boarding Greyhound and other buses and then interviewing the people on them. Now, to recap, in 2019, Mohamed El-Sheikh was a Portland-based comedian on his way back from a show in Pullman. Border Patrol agents got on his bus and started asking people questions. They pulled four people off that bus, including El-Sheikh, who's an asylee from Libya. El-Sheikh says they then demanded his papers, then accused his of being fake when he presented them. He says the agents were hostile and that none of the four people they interrogated were white. They eventually let him back on the bus, but El-Sheikh says the confrontation has stuck with him ever since.
I just started feeling like I'm not safe anymore. Throughout the past year, I tried not to even get a speeding ticket, or a parking ticket. I was just like, I'm trying to avoid law enforcement as much as possible. I do not want to give them any excuses to put me in any trouble.
So with the help of the ACLU and the Northwest Immigrant Rights Project, El-Sheikh sued the Border Patrol for detaining him without cause. And today they reached a settlement. The government will pay him and another man who had a similar experience $35,000 apiece.
The Border Patrol, they have to have a reason to arrest someone, right? It can't just be, well, I know you're from a foreign country, so I'm going to arrest you and detain you because maybe you're here unlawfully. That's not the case for lots of people who are here, even if they're from another country, right? So what it boils down to is under the Fourth Amendment, law enforcement has to have a reason to detain you, and that wasn't the case here.
The whole ordeal raised debate about that Border Patrol practice of bus checks. The city council tried to ban them, and then there was extensive debate, of course, about their legality. Right now, we are told Border Patrol is not currently boarding buses at the Intermodal Center. That's in part just because of operational changes made during the pandemic, but what also probably played a role, an internal memo leaked in which Border Patrol's own lawyers acknowledged agents need probable cause or consent from the bus company to board. After that memo, Greyhound announced they would end their practice of allowing agents onto their buses without any reason. El-Sheikh says for his part, he's pleased with the outcome, but glad this is all over.
Very happy that it's finally over and I don't need to think about it anymore. It's been 2 years and I just feel like the case has been in the back of my head this whole time. And I'm just happy that I don't have to think about it anymore. If it helped anyone avoid a situation like that, then it's been worth it.
We asked Border Patrol for comment tonight and we have not yet received any. In the newsroom, Casey Decker, Crime 2 News.